So everybody, welcome to the show. And today we have with us Dr. Siddharth Warrier. Do we call you Warrier or is it Warrier or is it Warrior?
No, it depends. If you are in Kerala, it's Warrior. Okay. And anywhere else, it's Warrier.
So welcome, Dr. Siddharth Warrier. He is a neurologist. And what interests me in this particular person is that the way brain works is essentially what neurology is all about. So the way he can put it for you in a way which you can understand is a skill that not everybody possesses.
What I want to introduce, the concept I want to introduce in today's discussion, if nothing else, is the concept of attention. Okay? So the word attention. So today, even if we don't understand anything else, if we can understand what the word attention means and how important it is, I feel that that would clarify a lot of our other doubts.
Absolutely.
So let's just think of what that means. So what do you think of when you hear the word attention? What comes to your mind? What does that word mean to you?
So the first thing that came to my mind when I heard attention is attention-seeking behavior. And that is something that I have come to understand is that you should avoid, or maybe at least remember, if you see such a trait in a person, then you have to keep a mental note that
this person,
keep distant. Them at arms, just flag them in such a way. And
that this is an attention seeking person. No, I absolutely. And so that is a very good starting point for our discussion that, there are people who will seek money. There are people who will seek success. There are people who seek power. But why would someone seek attention? Why is it important? Why does somebody crave attention? Currency is a very good way to put it. Because if you think about our language, we pay attention.
Yeah.
So even in our language, the way it has evolved, we have understood that in a way it is a form of currency. You pay someone attention, right? And then you get attention in return. So in a way, attention is like this undercurrent economy that is happening all around us. We pay attention to each other to get attention in return. And that is the currency in which society actually functions. So we are all paying attention to each other. The reason why this is so important is because in our brain, whether something exists or not depends on how much attention you give it.
Perfect.
It is so fundamental that the more attention you pay something, the more it becomes real. And the best example for this is pain. So for example, if you are comfortably walking in your house and your toe stubs against a table end, for example, and you are in severe pain, you are in excruciating pain, right? Somebody who is at war and they are running for their lives and they're trying to, you know, or they are attacking someone, they may get a bullet wound in their arm and they may not feel pain because of attention. Your attention is so completely focused on something else that you don't even feel that bullet wound at that time. So in a very fundamental level, attention makes things real and attention can stop making things real.
Now this is going in one of those mind-bending exercises. Whatever you see is pretty much what you give attention to.
Yes.
That is all.
That is all. And this is true at every level. When you're looking for something and your entire attention is focused on that, then other things will be less real. They will stop existing for a minute. And the weird thing is, as a human being, when you pay attention to me, I can feel that I am more real now in your life. And if you don't pay attention to me, I can feel that I am not real. And this is that sense of why somebody will get bothered when they don't get attention from somebody that they want attention from. So this is the basis of the silent treatment. Why the silent treatment is like a punishment. Ki main baat nahi karunga tere se. Why should that be a punishment? Why should it be a punishment? Like, you, I'm not hurting you. I'm not beating you. But I'm just ignoring you. That should not be a punishment, actually. But it is. It can be a very hurtful punishment. You can actually feel a lot of emotional pain when somebody ignores you. Why is that?
Right.
Because you're not getting attention. And in a very, very weird way, your own sense of self depends on whether other people are paying attention to you or not.
So, which makes me curious that a lot of how our mind or brain works has to do with our survival instincts, which were much more useful back in the day when you were a hunter-gatherer.
Correct.
So, does attention also stem from there? And was it of any survival value back then? Because, so in a way you can say that you can pay and get attention has some survival value for procreation. Mm-hmm. But that is still a small part of the whole lifespan that an organism lives, human being in this case. So was it ever a time when it was necessary for survival, like, you know, hunting, gathering activity? Because from what I gather is that you are attentive. Like, for example, if in the olden days, if you saw another creature which looks like you, you have to decide quickly whether it is going to eat you, or do you have to fight, or do you have to fly? So, so what is that the moment where attention became useful as a survival skill? I mean, is that the reason, or is there anything else?
Attention. So attention is important in two respects. Attention is important for survival, and attention is important for growth. So for survival, like you said, you need to quickly identify a potential predator or a prey. So that you cannot identify if you're not attentive. So your evolution has given a lot of, genetic rewards for people who are attentive. So people who can spot possible threats or possible survival benefits early on gets genetic rewards. So they get that sense of fulfillment and success whenever they pay attention to the right things. The social attention is actually like a offshoot of that. It is like a consequence of that. That came much later. So even in animals that didn't have too much of social cooperation, they still had look for predator, look for prey. Wo to fundamental hai. Wo to pehle se hi tha. But as the animals evolved, they learned to pay more and more attention to each other, pay attention to their family members, pay attention to their children. And then they got attention back. And then they learn to pay attention to other members of their species. And human beings are the pinnacle of that. Like, we are paying attention to, you know, everyone. So like, you and I are not anywhere in the same family. And yet right now, like, we have our undivided attention. So this is a level of cooperation that only human beings have been able to do. So it is all part of survival. But at some point, survival becomes growth. So we are not just about survival anymore. We are now about growth. So it is in that same spectrum.
Right. So, Abhin, the way I look at it, jo pehle political parties thi, aajkal wo social influencers hai. It is essentially a game of influence.
Yes.
The more you can influence four people, you are head of a family. You can influence 4 million people, you are chief minister of a state.
Absolutely.
You can influence 4 billion people, maybe you are prime minister of a country. Yeah, whatever.
Correct. Very well put. So absolutely.
Those things haven't changed.
Hmm.
And again, it boils down to grabbing attention. The more you can gather, the rich and more powerful you become.
Yes. So if you have the attention of that many people, then that gives you a sense of power.
Right.
So now coming back to your statement of attention seeking, you are actually talking of power seeking.
Oh, okay.
So in a way, attention is power.
is it normal to be attention seeking, or is it something that, you know, it is a trait which some people have and some people don't?
I think the answer is that it's a spectrum. So it's like eating. I mean, it's normal to eat. It's a problem if you don't eat at all, and it's a problem if you overeat. Similarly, like, everybody needs some amount of attention, right? So if you don't get any attention from your parents, that would be a problem. If you don't get any attention from your friends, that would be a problem, because then, this is where I was leading up to it. In a way, attention is how you define your own identity. So the kind of attention you get will define your identity, because think about it. Suppose you are a great painter and you have been sketching like these amazing paintings, and you're putting them out on the street and everybody ignores you. All your life, everybody ignores you. Not one person turns and says, wow. So in a way, not one person pays attention. Now, will you ever know that your paintings are good?
No.
No.
You might even doubt if they exist. They're like...
Yeah, exactly.
Hai bhi ki nahi.
Hai bhi ki nahi. Kyunki wo existence tumko kaise pata? Right. It is only when somebody pays attention that something becomes real. That's what I meant.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. Now, take it one step further. You exist. Suppose everyone ignores you.
Yeah. Suppose you are there and nobody... So that is a prank that, I don't know, at least I have played with my friends on people. Like, somebody walks in and they're like, nobody look at him, nobody talk to him, behave as if he's not there.
Yeah.
And within seconds, you're uncomfortable. What is the hell is this? Why is nobody talking to me?
Yes, because think about it. Why is that uncomfortable? You are not in any pain.
Yeah.
So why should that be uncomfortable?
Yeah, because then... You start questioning, can people see me? Are they angry? Are they not angry? Why am I not noticed? What is wrong with...
Yes. How do we see things? So if you have a tree in front of you, how are you able to see the tree?
Right.
So light is reflected off the tree, and then it hits your retina, and then you figure it out. Similarly, in a way, what attention is that you are putting out yourself, and attention is that reflection of other people back.
You can put it that way, yeah.
Yeah. So if you're not getting any reflection back, if you're not getting any feedback, that your brain starts to think that, okay, that maybe then that means I'm not putting anything out. And if I'm not putting anything out, that means I don't exist.
Hmm.
And that is a very scary thought. That is why you get uncomfortable. Yeah.
So let us talk about for a minute about people who say that I don't like attention, or maybe it makes me uncomfortable, or maybe people who are shy or introvert. So, so far we have been talking all about pro attention, that attention is necessary. It is normal. You pay, you get, it makes you exist, and so on and so forth. But there are often people who say that, I'm just happy by myself. I need two friends in my life, and I'm okay, cuddled up in my room in one corner, sipping coffee, watching movies. No attention. I don't want that.
Correct.
So then how do we explain this? Like,
So exactly in that same way, you want only that much attention that you identify with. There is two aspects to attention. One is the return, that you are putting something out and you are getting something back. But the other aspect of attention is that attention as an input. So when you take something in, you also have to put back something, because then your paying attention becomes the input for somebody else.
Right.
Right? So you're not just putting things out there. You're also replying to other people's attention. And that sometimes may be too much for some people. So when they say I'm getting too much attention, it also implies that I have to return that. Like I have to keep that conversation going. Yeah. And some people don't want to keep that conversation going.
Yeah. For reasons best known to them, but it
to
is
them. Huh. So they don't want to engage so much. So then the best way to do it is to reduce their own output. So if I don't put out so much, then I won't get back so much. So then I don't have to reply so much.
So it is an adaptation for their personality or the way they have designed themselves or have been designed by circumstances or whatever.
So in general, everybody up till a particular point will have the same amount of output and input. Like how much attention you give is usually how much attention you get within, you know, normal physiological limits. But sometimes it can get screwed over. Like sometimes there may be people getting far more attention than what they are giving. So like, for example, if there are people stalking someone, like that one person isn't paying any attention to them, but somebody is stalking them, like giving them too much attention, which is uncomfortable. Right?
Okay.
And even like superstars, for example, they are getting a lot more attention.
Yeah, correct.
So all famous people, basically. So fame is that. Fame is unequal attention.